Matthew Haldren's come a long way since helping his father fix up houses in Vermont. He's now a respected furniture designer with a booming business.
This material is what makes my work beautiful to me.
And like many other creative entrepreneurs, he was drawn to New Orleans in the desperate days following Hurricane Katrina.
I visited and really fell in love with the city. The music, the young people moving here who really had it in their heart, they wanted to be part of rebuilding the city.
And the influx of the young and the talented is obvious across the city. Shared workspaces like Beta in the heart of downtown are increasingly common, and New Orleans is now ranked as one of North America's biggest brain magnets, a trend that finance professor Peter Ricciotti says is a game changer.
The real difference after Katrina is it's raised the bar, it's raised the level of possibilities for the city and what people can do here.
There's little doubt then that this new generation of fresh blood has helped New Orleans stage a remarkable comeback. But when you come to neighborhoods like the Lower Ninth Ward, which was hit particularly hard by the storm, it's obvious some problems still endure.
Good job. Good job.
Problems that Sonny Lee is keenly aware of. He grew up in the Lower Ninth and now runs a program that mentors fatherless boys. Many people simply never return to his old neighborhood.
Whoever used to live here, the person across the street knew. The person, you know, this was a family, you know, in New Orleans, we're all a family. So to look across the street and not see your neighbor there, it's got to be an empty feeling, it's got to be a lonely feeling.
The picture for New Orleans then is of a slow but steady recovery. Thousands never returned after Hurricane Katrina, but many more have and are proud to call the Big Easy home. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, New Orleans.